In rhyme. Now, you remember Donny Dungheap had that really ugly daughter? Well, here she is, our special guest. Come in, Miss Cabbage Water.
In springtime and in summer, the thing I like the best to do is to get out of my doors and spend many happy hours tending to my little vegetables and plants and flowers.
Yeah!
Garden with its flora and its fauna, but the thing I really like the best is my little compost corner. My idea of heaven, and yours as well, I'm sure, is to be up to my fetlocks in all kinds of manure. To horses and to piggies and to cows for all their dung. No praise is too high or too great can ever quite be sung. With all this stuff within your soil, you'll get a lot of mileage. Oh, how I love that evil smell of all that rotting silage. My compost corners! Famous, people come from far and wide.
Like Roger Welf and Rodney, that wet from Wotherwide. Excuse me popping in, quiz. Please don't mind me butting in, but I'd just like to grab the chance to do a little bit chat and get this cutting in. It's a really wonderful hybrid Welsh. It smells a bit like lime. Can I do a little chat?
No, we haven't time. No, we haven't time. It's only fair to warn you, I've got another very special guest coming here on Compost Corner.
Well, me old pal, me old beauty. Oh, look at Miss Cabbage Water. She's a right here old cutie. Excuse me, there, lads. I just thought I'd get rid of that, me old sister. I be Gabriel Swamp, and my wife's name be Lorna. I got you there now, haven't I? And we did all our courting behind my compost corner.
Compost corner!
And now when I get a whiff of rotten eggs, cowpats and dung, I thinks of my dear wife and the happiness she has brung.
Well, thanks very much, good Gabriel, listen to my advice. Go off home and have a bath. You smell just like your wife.
Thank you. Be kind of you.
I was voted Miss Cabbage Water back in 47. I was also Miss Totness down in Bognor, down in Devon. I was also been Mother Haystack in Tring and California, but my lifelong ambition is the crown, Miss Compost Cornier.
Miss Compost Cornier!
Well, best of luck, young cabbage. I think you're bound to win.
You're just the right proportions, not too fat and not too thin.
Well, I thinks it should be a walk over unless you be double-crossed.
Her perfume smells of long-dead worms.
Her whiff of old compost.
And your dress sense be like a pig that's have a real good rummage.
Your face looks like a TV star.
Rackle Welsh?
No words will go. So best of luck, young cabbage. Your beauty really shows.
Aye, I'd like the Andy in my garden. To help to stir the crows or something like that. Just keep talking.
Excuse me, are you sure I haven't got time to send a quick message to my girlfriend, Roly Poly Rosemary Periwinkle? She's a rather rotund receptionist for the crew branch of Rolls Royce. I'll be getting home rather late tonight, and it's only fair to warn her.
No, you can't. We haven't time. That's all from the Compost Corner.
Oh, Compost Corner!
The miracle of the cathode ray tube brings you one of Sally, the fabulous Miss James's almost legendary pub interviews.
Fighting in the streets with our children alive.
Kenney. What happened to you two? I mean, you weren't too bad when you were being fouled in Compost Corner.
We just got thrown into your cage.
You got thrown in the
cage? We thought your cage was supposed to be locked.
Supposed to be? What
happened? Escaped.
They got a rope crew in there. They dragged you in and
a bit rotten. Yeah. Never mind, we have a special thing planned later which could clean you off. Need I say more? Roger, while you're watching that clip from Kids Are All Right, you were sort of groaning and saying, oh no, it's old-fashioned. You don't feel like seeing old stuff that you
don't. Long-haired hippies.
Yeah. Now, you're nearing the end of your first sort of proper British tour for, what, quite some time, isn't it?
Five years.
How's it been going? You've been pleased with the way it's been going?
Yeah, really good.
Yeah? Are you enjoying being back on the road now as much as, say, when you first started touring, however many years ago that might be? Do you still get the same buzz out of it as you did originally?
On stage, it's good.
Yeah. I mean, do you still get the same kick out of the business, having hit records? Does it still mean as much as when you first started?
It's great to have hit records, yeah.
Yeah, always. So that never wears off.
It's been a long time since we've had one.
How long is it?
4 years.
Is it really that long?
It feels like 4 years.
Yeah, it always seems a long time, doesn't it? Kenny, I know you've probably been asked this hundreds of times, but a lot of people have written in asking me to ask you. I mean, in a sense, you're the sort of new boy of the band, only been there a short time. I mean, how difficult was it for you to sort of fit in with the three others who've been together for so long?
I didn't find it difficult. The only thing I found difficult was learning the songs. I mean, I knew everybody for years, way back when I was in the Small Faces.
Yeah, it's just.
He's ever so hard to get on with, though.
Yeah,
I'm a real terror. Yeah. I always. He's
worse
with everybody.
Worse than Keith Young.
So that brings me to the next question: how do you all get on?
Like this.
Not very well. Now, I know that John is just nearing finishing a solo album. Pete's about to start one. What about you, Kenny? Have you got any solo plans?
I might have. If they pay me enough.
Nothing absolutely on the cards at the moment?
No, not yet.
Now, of course, Roger, you've been pursuing what has become a very successful film career. Have you any plans in films at the moment that you can reveal?
Yeah, I've got, hopefully, going to do one in the summer.
Yeah. Is that... Can you tell us what it's about?
It's about the British Army in the First World War.
Yeah.
And about a mutiny.
Yes.
And it's all very tentative, but hopefully it'll come together.
Is that something that you would be producing, starring in?
No, they've just asked me to play a part.
Oh, I see.
The lead part, but it's a great story. Actually.
Because you are into production as well, aren't you? And you do, in fact, own Shepperton Studios.
Yeah, but we run out of money.
Oh, have you? Yeah. So does that mean that there's nothing going to happen at Shepperton?
Well, it's very hard to get money, actually get people to put money into films in England.
Yes, I know.
It seems to be very easy in America, but in England they go, especially when it's The Who.
Well, they think that you're not...
They're all mad.
Really? I wonder how they could possibly get that idea, Roger.
I know.
I really don't know how that could happen, but it does seem that you've calmed down a bit, apart from today's sort of efforts. I mean, you do live quite a quiet life, don't you, away from it all?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Sort of, we've seen pictures of you in the paper, sort of, with your wellies trudging through fields.
Oh, it's very boring,
isn't
it?
He's a farmer. Is that not really true, then?
I live quite a quiet life.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm loony.
He's
normal, like the rest of you.
Locked up.
Like the rest of us. Now, there's a new album out in a couple of weeks' time. It's called, what's it called?
Face Dances.
And it's
nothing to do with us.
Yes, we know nothing about it.
Quite an exciting cover is planned for this. I mean, I'm sure the record's going to be exciting as well. But tell us a bit about this cover, because it sounds quite amazing. It's being unveiled to the world on Wednesday, isn't it?
All these very famous artists did paintings of all of us,
mm-hmm.
various different artists. All their names escape me at the moment.
David Hockney.
Yeah,
yes.
No, right.
Peter Blake designed it, didn't he? Alan Jones. Sergeant Pepper. Yeah.
And there's basically four paintings of us individually.
Great. Now,
that made a lot of sense.
Sort of it, didn't it? Never mind.
Anyway, there's 16 paintings by 16 different artists.
So, that's it. Yes, quite a superb.
And they're like the top contemporary artists of today.
Have you planned out the next year? Presumably, a group of your stature has to sort of work a lot in advance. I mean, have you planned
out? No, we go along day to day.
We live on our nerves.
It really is organised disorder.
Because if you're planning tours and like releasing records in all different countries, you've surely got to have a sort of plan of attack.
Our manager plans it, and then he tells us at the last minute.
And then you change it all.
If he shows it to us all written down...
That was more than interesting. Thank you very much indeed. We'll have plans for washing you lot down later. Now we're going to hear the single that's currently roaring up the charts. Here they are, here's The Who. Great for you to be on Tiswas. Here they are with you, Better You Bet. Thanks very much.
I clean my teeth, my clothes I scrub, I'm in the bucket of Water Supporters Club.
He's in the bucket of Water Supporters Club.
I
I like to drink it from out of a tap. A glass or two helps me bridge that gap. I like to drink it from a fast flowing river. I like it down my back, it makes me shiver. Now I don't even mind it from a plastic tub. I'm in a bucket of water supporters.
He's in the bucket of water supporters.
When people eat, they have a glass of wine. They say it's the only way to dine. Others like Chris with a pint of beer, now the French champagne from a vintage year. But H2O goes with my grub. I'm in the bucket of water supporters club.
He's in the bucket of water supporters club.
We work together as a united team. It's not as easy as it might seem. The rules of life make it to every game. If you get hurt, you're an end of blame. But if I get hurt, I'll always have a sub, cause I'm in the bucket of water supporters club.
He's in the bucket of water supporters club.
I'm down to the pool for a lovely dip. If there isn't any water, I feel such a drip. Now I don't want to be a brownie or a cup. I'm in the bucket of water supporters club.
She's in the bucket of water supporters club.
We're in good time, we're at the very
club. We're in the bucket of water supporters club. We're in the bucket of water supporters club.
Royal Marine Commandos in Linston.
Right. Very big with the Navy and Air Force. So
yes, quite
big. That's just about it, really, for another morning. I allowed you on. Just about it for another morning. Special guest next week amongst all sorts of people. Mike Harding's dropping in. This is your big day, though, isn't it?
I know, because the single came out yesterday. I'm really excited. It's called The Algernon Wants You to Say OK Song. It's really great.
You know, how do you think your life's going to change now that you're hoping to be a heavy rock star?
Yes, well, sadly, you know, I think I'll be able to league with The Who and all that kind of people, you know.
I will
be
able to
competition, eh?
How do you feel about him chasing you up the charts? Oh.
Well, this is the kind of thing, you know, we'll be able to share DCM sandwiches and Shady Gold records and all that kind of thing. It's going to be really, really great.
Who do you think's been the greatest inspiration on your musical career to date?
Yeah. Mussolini.
Yes, I've heard.
Because he was into that kind of thing, you know. He was into saying, okay, it's a really great. You know, I think he's fine. I think he's really cool.
Well, I tell you what, get yourself over the other side of the studio. Very soon, you've got about 2,000 children waiting to join along.
Okay.
Off you go.
Off you go.
Here we go with Algernon's classic. We'll leave you for this week with Algernon's classic, the OK song.
Great! Come